Now, maybe we want to actually fight the Leyendale Knight down below before we go up and deal with Boglins. It's been a hot minute since I last played as Lulu, though, so I forget if there's any Boglins on the way to that knight. I just remember the knight himself because of the trauma of it all. It would mean, though, that we can't just sprint past these buggers. That one's got glowy eyes, lovely. Ouch. ₹1,200, nice. It could have gone worse. Now, is there one around this corner? There's one around a corner. Can we lure them out by just bashing the wall of it? Or do we have to actually expose ourselves to their sneak attacks? Ouch. Bloody... Oh, come on now. The way their jumping attacks track is just the worst thing. Actually, before I forget, let's have a look at our flasks, because I want to check if my wondrous physic is as efficient as it could be right now. Let's see. So we've got stamina and thing. I mean, Cerulean Hidden Tear would just allow us to Dragon Breath the heck out of people for a few seconds. So that could be fun. Now let's try flame slinging the buggers instead of just marching in with our fists. Fists are supposed to be the backup option. Yeah. Splash damage on these pots is the worst. And we're dead again. This dungeon, basically, is the second worst dungeon I've found. It doesn't help that these Boglins just can't be lured out of place. They will just stand there and throw pots for the rest of time. Ugh. Yeah, the splash damage. I think it's possibly just worse because I'm in water, but I'm not sure. Oh god, the damage is ludicrous. Maybe we do just sprint past them. I mean, we also need better armor, but better armor's not going to help against all this non-elemental damage. And we've got the Pearl Drake Talisman plus one, so we should be taking way less non-elemental damage. So are these guys supposed to be hitting even harder than they are? Ugh. Look at that, that's half our health gone. And then they chase you down as well. And they probably follow you down here. Yes, at least some of them are following us. There's all these knobheads to deal with as well. Is that a pressure plate? It is. That's kind of cool. Did that get the Boglin? No. Right, you lot can bugger off. Oh, we're bit. Never mind. That's you done. Good. Now, why is that on our back? That's fine, I guess. Oh, piss off. I was trying to sort my inventory out for a second. Right, so we've lost most of our stuff at this point. Now we've got this lad. And I've forgotten to change to my wrath attack. Let's see if we can't sneak up the old ladder while he suffers from rot on the way up. Then when he gets up here... Oh, he fell off. Did the rot damage him? To the point where he just fell off the ladder? Is he giving up? Is he confused? Is he fighting someone else? What is happening down there? That doesn't make any goddamn sense. But I'll take it, I guess. What in God's name happened down here? I shouldn't go and check because we're about to get grabbed by all these lads again, probably. But yeah. Maybe he got into a fight with some slimes. What a confusing victory. And now, yeah, there's another boglin, isn't there? What is that? Is that firing from behind? Yeah, good. Oh, he's up in the ceiling. Son of a bitch. Ah, come on now. Ugh. This place. Everything about this place. It's the worst. Do we have a stone sword key? We do. Good. Was it worth using it? Let's find out. Lightning scorpion charm. No. No, it was not. Raises lightning attack but lowers damage negation. Amazing. Right, so we've got a boggo up there. We could use a bow of some sort. Now, are you just going to stay up there? Because it might take a while, but we could probably headshot you to death. Maybe. Although, how did that miss? Yeah, this could take a while. And also, we don't have many arrows, so... It's basically, it's not going to work. If we can push him out of the way, just by pushing him further and further back until he can't throw pots at us anymore, then that would be kind of victory. And if we can take him down to within one hit at least, so when he inevitably drops down... Well, we almost got him. Thus Lulu's adventures with a bow come to an end. And where's the attack? Oh, there isn't an attack. Do we go down there? That seems like a poor idea. There we go. Now there's another knight. Oh, there's another boglin over there. I bet we could jump by another boglin. Yeah, of course we do. Now those heavy strikes were pretty cool. That's good. Now, taste our flames. And some more of our flames. Nice. That's what the old infinite FP will get you. Finally the lever. Ah, thank goodness for that. Now we can die in peace and go back to the entrance. There best be a sick reward at the end of this place. Or... Well, I'll be mildly annoyed. Mm. You're onto us, are you? Boggo. Around the corner. I dare you. Too clever for that? Maybe. You can be backstabbed. That's fun. Ah, oh, but now we've got to run past the boggos to get back because I didn't kill any of them. I just scarpered. But that's fine. Don't matter if we die. We can get more runes whenever we like. Now, we've still only got a +2 Engvar. Have we not picked up any more glove warts to make him better? I'd like to go check. May as well. We've got a handful of runes on us. We still haven't got Ghost Glove Wart 3. Did that Catacomb have any glove warts in it? Are we going to have to go back to a lame, low-level Catacomb at some point? Oh yeah, we were using Crepus's thing, weren't we? Because we don't actually need the stats for it. So we don't actually need this, because we can just use bolts and whatnot. Why is a whetstone knife for sale? Do we not own a whetstone knife? It'd be under key items, wouldn't it? So maybe we don't. I mean, we don't need one. But still, it's curious nonetheless. And if the reward in here isn't spectacular, then this is the last time you'll see Wyndham Catacombs in this MEGAPLAY. We'll have a sip, and we'll have a sip of that one. Now this lad can't be rotted, it seems, but he can probably be frostbitten. We'll just wait for Engvar to get his attention again. Ah, as if we didn't get the riposte. Nice. Good job, Engvar. Just about. Glovewort Picker's Bell Bearing 1. Interesting. I guess that's us just regular glove warts. We'll find out. But either way, that seems like it might be a good reward. If they do make you get separate bell bearings for glove warts and ghost glove warts, though, that will be mildly annoying. But they do that with the Smith and Stone, so it wouldn't be that much of a surprise. And we'll offer Topes his bell bearing as well, because why not? Yep, it's just grave glove warts. 1, 2, and 3. So at least you get 3 of them. Rather than just 2 like you do with the smithings. But yeah, we need to find out where the ghost ones are, probably. Right, bit the old sneaky sneaky, I'll take this lad out. Hoppa! Well, got close to taking this lad out. There we go. Now there's a lovely scroll. Always welcome. We should probably go back down the lift, actually. Just kill the lad down there and pick up the sorcery that's hanging around. Because it might be worth it. Hi, friend. Now, there's items over here. And then we can get the lift back up to where I actually want it to be, I think. Die. Thank you. Nope. Don't want you flailing. Get off me. Hate those buggers. Oh yeah, that's where we get the other soldier ashes. Kind of cool. But they're not archers, so do we care? This should hopefully take us back to where we can scrap with that lad for a sorcery thing. Yeah, there's the bridge. Oh. Cool. Now. What sort of magic do we want? Probably zoned shards is fine. Although, looks like he might be one of those buggers that likes to dodge on spellcast. Ouch. And also we're out of magic. Ouch. Nice try. Our try was not much nicer, to be honest. But we got the job done, eventually. And we got gravity well. Is that necessary? Eh. Maybe not. But we are kind of using gravity sorcerers in general, so maybe. It's probably not as good as rock sling, though, to be fair. Maybe if you combo it with a big AoE spell. Could be used to grind on those Albinorics in Moog's Palace. Perhaps. Was there any other loot around here worth grabbing? I don't think there was. Well, bam! We're sneaking up. And we're gonna stab you up, good. Stab, stab, stab. Stop hitting me with books, you fucking nerds. Yeah, it could have gone worse. Yeah, we're going to have to deal with all these lot, aren't we? So, let's do just that. Oi. Ah, piss. Oh, Pot Boy got in the way. Enough out of you, Pot Boy. Bits of dead warrior everywhere. Now, this douchebag. Get dead. Oh yeah, we've got a third talisman slot free, ready already for that Graven Sorcerer thing that we're going to pick up. Yeah, I think that's everything cleared out for now. Let's see what we got. We've got the Comet spell, haven't we? Hmm. That could be fun. What's the stats on that like? 52. Yep, we're not using that for a while. I'm gonna stab up some pots. Any more? Yep. Got a bonk off, but that's fine. Raises the potency of sorceries. Mm. Lovely. But do we want to use sorceries? In the old punch-up that's ahead? How much FP have we got? So maybe for this first attempt we'll switch to a different summon just so we can get one out. And the marionette soldiers are pretty cool. Because I don't want to have to drink one of my two blue flasks before I even get to do anything. So now we can drink. Now we can try and wreck up this lab. Mostly fail because, yep. Yeah, I don't know if they did much for us, but it's just too fast to hit with spells. Jumping stabs, but yep, jumping stabs again. It could be worse. Ah, balls. And roll. And jumping stabs. And we actually got him. That was unexpected. Marionettes did next to nothing, but they were level 0, so it's only fair. And that's another level. We could go for more vigor. Basically saved our ass there. Mind? We will need more mind, overall. Let's go for a bit of mind. Why not? Didn't seem to be the type to actually, yeah. He doesn't seem to be interested in thingamajig. Oops. Yeah, he's not rolling so much when I cast spells, so that's cool. Although he is when his shield's down, so now we'll use Rock Sling. Ouch. Got him. Fought well, friend. But now you're deed. Now these two don't actually want to fight. Which is fine with me. If they don't want to fight, then I'll kill them anyway. I never said Cherry is a nice cat. Now let's stab up this lad, see what damage he's like. It's good enough for a one-shot kill. So I guess we can do the same to the lad that causes balls to drop. Nice. Whoop. Whoop. Leave me be, friends. I have business to attend to downstairs. Now, as ever, we should probably check if we've been to the Church of Vows before. Although we're in combat, so there we go. Yeah, I've been to the church, so we don't need to teleport there now. Kablams! How have these lads got so much poise? It's ridiculous. They're nerds, for goodness sake. Right, so do we try the rooftops now, or do we replenish our stuff first? We'll probably replenish our stuff, and also we'll bob down here and get the golden seed and stab up a crab. You're not the crab. You're the crab. I wonder if there's any lore reason why glintstone crowns are hidden on crabs. Were they mages that have turned into crabs? Is that a thing that happens? If you get really good at magic, you just turn to a crab. I mean, it's possible. I'm no mage expert.